Hi, it's me, Frasier. Listen, I'm aware of the time. It's just that, well, you're the last person on Earth I thought I'd be calling, but I had this dream, and I had to talk to you about it.
Oh, God. I suppose you expect me to be awake for this conversation, don't you?
Okay, I'll be brief. It's just that I'm on vacation with my girlfriend, Claire. A woman who, by all conventional measures, is perfect for me, and yet I've just had a vivid sexual dream about someone who differs from her entirely.
A man.
Not that different.
Someone you've slept with.
Well, yes, but it didn't work out. You see, I worshipped her for years, and then we had a parting over the ways because it turned out that she was just unpleasant and confrontational. Self-centered.
Frasier, if you're dreaming about me, just say it.
No, Lilith, it's not you. It's a woman named Lana.
Well, this seems like a textbook simple dream. Why are you calling me?
Well, because you know me better than anybody else, and you're a terrific psychiatrist.
Thank you.
So what do you think?
As a working hypothesis, I'd say you have the hots for Lana.
No, you see, maybe I'm not making myself clear. You see, the woman irritates me no end. She's antagonistic and opinionated, critical.
So I see. What you're saying is that unlike most women you've dated, she challenges you.
But maybe so, but that's not the point. You see, Claire is perfect for me.
All right. Why does this dream about Lana upset you?
I don't know.
Are you sure?
Lilith, do you think I know how to be happy?
Of course you do. You just like a challenge. You've never been one to take the easy road.
Well, it seems I've skidded right off the road this time and into a ditch. A deep one.
Well, you could try to throw it in reverse and spin your wheels for a while, or you could get out into the ditch and get yourself a little dirty.
I see. Lana's the ditch, right?
It's your metaphor.
Yes, well, I guess I've got some thinking to do. Thanks for talking, Lilith.
Anytime. I love you, Frasier.
I love you, too.